Welcome back to our channel. In this video, let us see how to write the JavaScript program to drive the vehicle on the road. As we can see, green car is the player car which moves based on the key press. Here, there is a background color which is a container that holds the road. Road is a fixed component which is black in color at the center of the container, and it has the boundary with dashed white color. The road with the boundary is a fixed component, it is not moving. There are three other components which are movable items on the container. The first one is our player car, which is green in color. It moves based on the key press, that is by event handling. The second movable component on our container is the road lines. As we can see, there are white lines at the center of the road which moves from top to bottom as the player car moves from bottom to top. These road lines moves in the direction opposite to the player car. The third movable component in the road is indicated in yellow cars, which are other vehicles on the road. So we are going to drive without colliding with other vehicles on the road, and we will drive within the road boundary. Coming to the implementation portion, I have index.html file with title given as drive car. Let me first give styling for the container and the road. As mentioned, container is the background color which I am choosing it as yellow green, and it contains the road. Road is at the center of the container with width 400 pixel and height 100 VH, that is 100% of viewport height, with background color set to black and margin auto, position relative, boundary left and right are 7 pixel, dashed and white in color. As we remember, the road has the boundary of dashed white, its width is 7 pixel. In the body portion of the HTML, let me have the container class which holds the road class. On loading the index.html in the website, we can see that road is black in color, boundary with dashed white colors, on the container yellowish green. We have now made the static road. We will next have our car and line at the center of the road. In the styling portion for the car, we will define, we will give the properties for the car as width 50 pixel and height as 80 pixel, background color set to black so that it will coordinate with the background color of road, and position is absolute to the road because the car and the lines will be on the road. From the bottom, we will set the car position at 120 pixels from the bottom. I have the car image as green.jpg and I have given URL of that. For the line properties, it's of width 10 pixel and height 100 pixel. Position absolute shall be in white color. Margin left is 195 pixel. I'm giving margin left as 195. Because if we recollect, road width is 400 pixel, the center of the road is 200 pixel, and if the line width is 10 pixel, so from 195 to 205 pixel are our lines. If we place margin left at 195, the lines will be at the center of the road. Coming to the script, JavaScript, we will create a document.query selector for our road and take it to the const variable road area. Init is the call for the function. In the init, as the name indicates, we will set all other components on the road. First, now we will have the player car and lines displayed on the road. As we have mentioned, player car, lines and other vehicles on the road are dynamic components. So we are creating it with let variable player car, create div class car and append this player car to the road area. Similarly, lines, we create the div class with set attribute to class line and append it road lines to the road area. So road area has the child of player car green in color and the road line. Here we could see at the top center there is a small line. Now we have to repeat these lines throughout the height. Purposefully we have created the road line only at the top. As we have seen, the road line should have the effect of moving down when the player car moves to the top. So if there is a gap between the lines, we can create this effect of moving down. I'll take a for loop and x 0 to 5 so that the lines will be repeated 5 times, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and take the value of x multiplied by 150 and assign it to y, which in turn is the position of the road lines from top. As we recollect, road line height is set to 100 pixel, and to include the gap, I have considered 100 plus 50, which comes to 150. I'm reloading the page. We can see there are 5 lines getting repeated. Between them, there is a black portion, because when every time x varies from 0 to 5, the y value, that is from the top, it's x multiplied by 150. 150 is arrived considering 100 as the height of the line plus additional 50 pixels. So we got 5 lines positioned one below the other. The player car is positioned from the bottom 120 pixels. Now we will see how to move the player car first. Player car will be moved based on the events from the player. The event here are the arrow up, arrow down, arrow left and arrow right. So these 4 key events are initialized to false and assigned through an array to a variable called keys. We also have the player variable with step initialized to 5. The step will be used to move the defined number of 5 pixels whenever the key event happens. So we will add listen handler for key up and down. If any key is pressed down, it will call a function called key down, and on releasing, that is press and release the key up function will be called. As we can see, function key down takes the key event as its parameter, and if that key event is in the keys array, set that key value to true. On releasing the key, we will write back false to those key events in the keys array. So here we have the player steps defined and key events are listened through JavaScript. Now based on the key press, we have to move the player car, our green car, by the defined steps in the direction based on the particular key. So coming to the init function, let us have player.start to true, which indicates that our play area is in progress. We will call another function play area with Windows request animation frame API, and we will set player.x position and player.y as same as the green car, that is player car offset left and offset top, so that player represents the player car. Now we will define the function play area, which will be called from init. Play area is the main function which should be called periodically, and the periodicity is by calling Windows request animation frame and passing the same play area as its parameter. We will check if the player.start is true and see if any of the key is pressed. Before that, let us declare a player car variable which will take the properties of car that we have defined in the style. This is done using the document.querySelector API provided by JavaScript. As we know, road area is black in color of width 400 and height 100% of the screen. We will call road area dot get bounding client rectangle. This is an API which will return 8 parameters. The 8 parameters are left, bottom, right, top, x, y, width and height. So we are going to get these 8 characteristics of road area and store it into the variable road. Now if the player.start is true, we are going to look for any key press. Here the valid key presses are arrow up, down, arrow left and right. When arrow up is pressed, and if the current player dot top, that is dot y, is greater than the road top, then we have to stop the movement. Stop movement in the sense we should ensure that the player car is not going away from the top position of display area. So we will ensure that it is there at the maximum top boundary by player.y minus the speed. Then for down, if the arrow down key is pressed, we have to ensure that the player car is not going to the bottom screen away from the display position. Hence check if current player.y position is less than road bottom minus 80. Here I have taken 80 because 80 is the height of our player car. As we can see, player with step values initialized to 5. So for each of these key move activities, we will ensure the movement happens at the increment of 5 pixels. That is why player car dot style dot top is equal to player dot y plus px. The value of player.y is converted to pixel and then assigned to the player car style top position. Based on left and right movement, we will assign player car left position with player.x value. Once again, we will understand this player area function. We will declare player car with document query selector of car. We already have road area object. For this road area object, we will get the get bounding client rectangle, which will return 8 parameters as I have mentioned. If the player dot start is true, which is set in the init function, then we will check for 4 key event handling. Here road top plus 80 is considered because 80 is the car height, so we should cover up that 80 also and limit the movement at top and bottom. Similarly, here width minus 64 is considered 64 because the car width, player car width, is 50 plus boundary of the road on two sides is 7 pixels. So road width minus 64 is the movable area for the car along the x-axis. After getting player x and y based on the key movement, we are assigning it to the player top and left positions. I am reloading the index.html file. As we can see, when I press up, it moves till the top and it clearly has the boundary. It is not moving away from the top visible or bottom visible portion. Similarly, left and right extreme ends are also clearly made. Pressing further to the left restricts its movement. Now we have moved the player car, we will keep moving the lines at the center of the road. As we recollect, when we move the car forward, lines at the center of the road will be moving backward, which gives the effect of driving the car on the road. So let us call the function move lines in play area and start defining move lines. Move lines will depend on the class line. So let me have the variable road lines and get the line style object using document query selector all. For each of the lines in road lines, I say each of the lines because if we recollect, we are appending 5 lines to road area. So road lines dot for each API is called and pass item for each inside the function as a parameter. Check if the line e dot y is greater than 700. That's from the top. If it is greater than 700, reassign the value of item dot y to 700 minus 750, which will result in minus 50. That means it will, after coming to the bottom, it will go to the top at minus 50 and once again scroll down. Assign this new item y with pixel to the item style dot top. So it gives an effect that line keeps moving down, and on going out of screen at the bottom, it again starts back at the top minus 50 position and it keeps coming down. We can see our lines at the center of the road are moving down, and on doing a key press up left and right, our player car is moving in steps of 5 pixels. Now the other portion that is pending is on the road, there will be other vehicles. So we have to drive considering other vehicles. For that, again, we will go to the CSS styling portion. And I am going to take same properties as our player car. Let me call this as vehicle. it shall take same width, height, background color from bottom 120 pixel. Only the image I am going to change to lo.jpg. Here other vehicles I am going to differentiate with yellow color on the road. And as this other vehicle are also movable components, in the init we will ensure that these vehicles appear on the road randomly. The vehicles are expected to be at random. They cannot be fixed like the road lines. Road lines are fixed at the center of the road, equidistant from the left and right border, and they have the defined height. But here vehicles are, we have defined its properties width as 50 and height as 80 pixel, but they shall appear randomly when we drive through the road. So first we will create the vehicle document, create element div with set attribute class for the vehicle, and set vehicle dot y position, that is from the top it shall be x plus 1 multiplied by 300, and the whole shall be multiplied by minus 1. Minus 1 because they can alternate between positive and negative values. Assign this vehicles dot y as pixel value to vehicle start dot vehicle style dot top. When new vehicle starts appearing on the road, we are giving the top and left position. For vehicle dot style dot left, I have used math dot random, and the random value shall be within the range of 350, because the width of the road is 400 and our vehicle width is 50 pixel. So the random position for the left can be from 0 to 350. Remaining 50 is for the vehicle width. The for loop is from 0 x less than 4. So maximum at a time I am keeping only 4 vehicles, other vehicles apart from the player vehicle on the road. And this other vehicle will also be in the driving or moving condition. So we will call a function called move vehicles. Like move lines, move vehicle should also be moving as per the steps that we have defined, and these steps will be incremented with the key press. Before that, let us have the variable vehicles, which takes document dot query select all. Here it is query select all because there is more than one vehicles assigned to the road area container. For each of the vehicles, inside the function pass the items and check if the item dot y, that is from the top, if the vehicle is greater than 750 position, then reposition it at minus 300. Minus 300 is at the top, but it's above the visible area, so it will take some time for that to come down and get visible. So it's like more vehicles keep coming when some vehicle moves down. When new vehicle is positioned at minus 300 from top through item dot y, the item's left value should also be defined, as originally we will use math random and its value shall be within 350. Use floor to seal it down and with pixel assign it to style dot left. We can see we have other vehicles of yellow color on the road and they keep appearing. But one thing here to be noticed is when the player car, when I give key press, it's moving, but it keeps moving even on hitting the other cars. So we have to do collision detection of the player car with other cars. The collision can happen on four sides. Player car bottom can hit other car top. So coming back to the function move vehicle, inside the vehicles dot for each item check, before setting the position of y, we will check if the player car has collided with any of these vehicles. So we will take player car parameter as input to this function move vehicles, and let us have the variable player car boundary, which shall take the player car get bounding client rectangle. This is a API in JavaScript which will give 8 parameters. Already we are using this API for road area. Then for each of the item in the vehicles, that is for other car boundary also, we will get using item dot get bounding client rectangle. Again, this get bounding client rectangle is a built-in API which returns 8 parameters: left, bottom, right, top, x, y, width and height. There are 4 possible sides for collision with other vehicles. They are the player car's bottom. If it hits other car's top, that's a collision. If the player car's top goes and hits at the back of the other car, that's also a collision. Then if the player car's left side goes and hits the other car's right, it's a collision. And the fourth collision can happen if the player car right hits the other car's left. So these are the 4 possible collision of the player car with other cars. We have got the player car's bottom, top, left, right positions using the JavaScript API get bounding client rectangle. Similarly, we have got other vehicles on the road, the yellow color vehicles on the road, bottom, top, left and right positions using get bounding client rectangle, and it is stored in other car boundary variable. So it's easy for us to check all these 4 conditions. If any of these conditions are met, then we have to stop the driving. For that, we will set the variable player.start equal to false, because play game will be executed only if it is true. As we can see, player car collided to the vehicle. and it stops again reloading. It has collided at the back of other vehicle. Again I am reloading it. Now it has, player car has collided to the right side of the other vehicle. We can keep playing, and if it collides, driving is stopped. So without colliding with other vehicles, I keep moving. So we have implemented HTML, CSS, JavaScript for driving the car on the road. I will walk through this code quickly from top to bottom. We have the container with background color as yellow green of full size, and road is 400 pixel by 100 viewport. Background color is black and border left and right are 7 pixel dashed white color. And we have the car class with this 50 by 80 pixel background black, and it's an image stored with URL. Vehicle also has the same property as the car, except that it's an another image called as yellow.jpg. Lines are at the center of the road, so margin left is 195 pixel, width of 10 pixels. We have a class container which contains the road class. Coming to the JavaScript, road area is a constant which takes document.query selector of the road. Player step is incremented by 5. 4 keys are initialized to false, arrow up, down, left and right. We add the event listener. When the key is pressed down, this corresponding key will be set to true. On release, it will be set to false. Move line function ensures that the lines at the center of the road are moved from top to bottom. Init is the function that will be called first in JavaScript. As the name indicates, function init shall set the player.start to true and call window request animation frame API and pass play area. We are having the class for player area and append it to the road area. It is append as child. Similarly, lines are repeated 5 times and append it to road area. Vehicle, 4 vehicles maximum, and they are placed randomly using math.random for left, and for the top it shall be a function of the for loop x. And this vehicle is also appended to the road as append child. So road area has road lines, player car and other vehicles. Coming to the play area, this takes a road area get bounding client rectangle, and if the player.start is true, it calls move lines, move vehicles by passing the current player car, checks for the key press and moves the player car by setting the new top and left position. Move vehicle shall take the parameter of this player car, and it shall check if there is any collision with other cars on the 4 sides, bottom, top, left and right. If there is a collision, stop driving by setting the player.start variable to false. Otherwise, reposition the top value. If it goes out of display, then again randomly place the left position. So this is the complete walkthrough of JavaScript for driving the car.